Hello and welcome to our annual celebration of the life of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. I'm honored to have you with us today. Our students and staff have worked very hard to prepare today's program for your viewing pleasure. This year's theme embodies the spirit of Dr. King with A Dream of Unconditional Love. We will commemorate his years of service and exemplify the virtuous life he lived. Dr. King dedicated his life to his dream of equality, unity, and showing unconditional love to one another. What a powerful word that is, love. In Dr. King's blueprint speech, he shared, "In your life's blueprint must be a commitment to the internal principles of beauty, love, and justice. Don't allow anybody to pull you so low as to make you hate them." Dr. King would never get to see the impact his life's work left upon our world, but his words and teachings serve as a compass for equality and our continued commitment to creating a better future for all. Please join me today as we celebrate and honor the life of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Thank you.
On October 15, 1962, in a speech that inspired a generation of Cornellians, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. said, "I am convinced that men hate each other because they fear each other. They fear each other because they don't know each other, and they don't know each other because they don't communicate with each other. And they don't communicate with each other because they are separated from each other." Further, Martin Luther King often spoke of the need for unconditional love. In 1955, he told Black America, "We want to love our enemies. Be good to them. This is what we must live by. We must meet hate with love. We must love our white brothers, no matter what they do to us." Dr. Martin Luther King later wrote, "It was quite easy for him to think of a God of love, mainly because he grew up in a family where love was central. That is what Reverend King preached all of his life, love. Love for each other, for neighbors, and for his fellow Americans. Dr. King's faith in his love for humanity led him and so many heroes courageously stand up for civil rights of African Americans. That is a whole lot of love, especially if it is the kind that says we love you no matter what you do or say about us. I am not discounting the power of love, but celebrations of King focus on his dream and what he saw at the mountaintop, because those things focus on the hoped for end result, racial justice brought about by love. In closing, are we as a nation striving to reach Dr. Martin Luther King's dream of unconditional love?
Your Majesty, Your Royal Highness, Mr. President, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I accept the Nobel Prize for Peace at a moment when 22 million Negroes of the United States are engaged in a creative battle to end the long night of racial injustice. I accept this award on behalf of a civil rights movement which is moving with determination and a majestic scorn for risk and danger to establish a reign of freedom and a rule of justice. I refuse to accept the view that mankind is so tragically bound to the starless midnight of racism and war that the bright daybreak of peace and brotherhood can never become a reality. I refuse to accept the cynical notion that nation after nation must spiral down a militaristic stairway into the hell of nuclear annihilation. I believe that unarmed truth and unconditional love will have the final word in reality.
What is unconditional love? In Christian terms, unconditional love is love that doesn't depend on the attitudes or actions of the beloved. It is a self-sacrificing love which finds its ultimate expression in Christ's sacrifice on the cross. In Romans chapter 5, verse 8 says, "But God shows his love for us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us." Martin Luther King often spoke of the need for unconditional love. In 1955, he told Black America, "We want to love our enemies, be good to them. This is what we must live by. We must meet hate with love." King spoke about the Greek concept of agape, or brotherly love and compassion, a social concept he defined as understanding, creative, redemptive, good will for all men. Further, he said, "Love is the greatest force in the universe. It is the heartbeat of the moral cosmos. He who loves is a participant in the being of God," Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Finally, Dr. Martin Luther King stated, "I believe that an unarmed truth and unconditional love will have the final word in reality. This is why right temporarily defeated is stronger than evil triumphant."
Oh, give him a shout!
What have other historical figures said about love? "I feel that there is nothing more truly artistic than to love people," quoted Vincent van Gogh. "Love and compassion are necessities, not luxuries. Without them, humanity cannot survive," quoted Dalai Lama. Love is friendship that has caught fire. It is quiet, understanding, mutual confidence, sharing and forgiving. It is loyalty through good and bad times. It settles for less than perfection and makes allowances for human weaknesses. Quoted Ann Landers. Let us always meet each other with a smile, for the smile is the beginning of love, said Mother Teresa. Love is not only something you feel, it is something you do, said David Wilkerson.
A dream of unconditional love. As a member of the U.S. Congress, my primary responsibility would be to serve and represent all Americans with compassion and empathy. In 2024, I firmly believe that our nation must foster an environment that demonstrates unconditional love for every individual, regardless of their background, race, religion, or socioeconomic status. This essay delves into five key areas where congressional action can help America openly embody this core: education reform, healthcare accessibility, criminal justice reform, immigration policies, and community engagement initiatives. As a public servant, I would work endlessly to create a society that is fair and just for all Americans. I trust we can build a better and inclusive nation for the next generations. To display unconditional love for all U.S. citizens, we must prioritize education as a primary right to accessible to everybody. I would advocate for extended educational reforms aiming to lower differences between urban and rural schools while promoting honest access to quality education across America. As a society, we need to understand that education is the key to unlocking a brighter future and should be available to everyone, regardless of their background or economic status. By investing in our children, education, we are investing in the future of our nation. Absolute love demands equal access to healthcare for every citizen. To fulfill this goal, I would propose legislative actions focused on expanding Medicaid coverage nationwide. I would advocate for reduction of prescriptions, drug costs. I would also support mental health initiatives that would further show our commitment to providing quality over all Americans without prejudice based on income or pre-existing conditions. I would also promote medical research and innovation that focus on developing new treatments for disease and chronic conditions. I believe that funding for medical research and innovation will provide the overall quality of healthcare and the discovery of life-saving treatments that can benefit all Americans. The current criminal justice system disproportionately impacts marginalized communities. To demonstrate our commitment to unconditional love for all U.S. citizens, I would focus on implementing comprehensive criminal justice reform measures at a national level that would include ending required minimum sentences, promoting options for incarceration, such as restorative justice programs, and investing in community-based rehabilitation initiatives. Focusing on rehabilitation rather than punishment, we can encourage a system that generally supports individuals in their journey towards rejoining society. Regardless of a person's country of birth, I will seek comprehensive immigration reform and that reflects Americans' commitment to unconditional love for all U.S. citizens. The involvement creates a pathway to citizenship for undocumented immigrants who contribute positively to our community. They are ensuring border security measures are humane and respectful for human rights by valuing diversity, we can create a more vibrant, prosperous America that celebrates the unique contributes of all citizens. It is necessary to invest in grassroots organization and encourage civic engagement among citizens. We can make progress towards a more equitable and just society. Our proposed lawmaking supporting local nonprofits and community centers. Additionally, I would withhold the performance of nationwide volunteer programs that bring together people from diverse backgrounds. They will collectively address social problems such as poverty, homelessness, and racial injustice. By working together, we can create a better future for all Americans. If I was a U.S. Congress member, I would strive to show love and compassion for every individual of our nation. Bold legislative efforts in education, healthcare, criminal justice, immigration, and community engagement industries. We can build an inclusive society where everyone feels supported. Maintaining these regulations will not only strengthen our nation, but will serve as an example to the world, reflecting the spirit of our unity and an understanding that we hold dear. Thank you.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Cheryl Montz. I will be presenting awards today. We will begin with the essay awards, and so we will add Ms. Madison Bressman, an eighth grader at MacArthur Middle School. Her teacher is Mrs. Kimberly Hooper. Would you come forward, please, Ms. Bressman? Congratulations. Our next awardee, if you would come forward, please, is Ms. Bernita Taylor. Ms. Bernita Taylor is from the MIT. I want to tell you a little bit about who they are and what they're doing in the community. They have been here for many, many years, and anywhere you look, you're going to see something that they're doing. They feed at different sites. They have a community garden, community food drive. They partnered with United Way, and they are just doing a wonderful job. They help the Achievers serve up to 20 youth at a time. They feed at the Boys and Girls Club. So this plaque reads, in recognition of their many years of service to the Lawton Fort Sill community, we recognize you January the 16th, 2024, for your service to this community. Thank you so much. Our next awardee, if you would come forward, is Mr. and Mrs. Randall. And as a recipient of Community Service Award, if you see these two young people, they are all over this community. They came to Lawton and they have been on fire ever since then. We want to thank them for all the things that they do. They help the Salvation Army Boys and Girls Club. They also have the teen court. They work with the Lawton Food Bank. They work with Lawton Public Schools Foundation. They are with the Arts for All, United Way, Starlight Concert, and the list goes on and on. This award was developed to honor persons who are making significant contributions, actions, talents, and dedication in the spirit of Dr. Martin Luther King. On this day, January the 16th, 2024, we would like to present you with the Community Service Award. Thank you for all you do.
Thank you so much. Thank you
very much.
Appreciate it.
Thank you. We have our high school recipient for essay, so we would like LaIndia Perry to come forward. She's from MacArthur High School. She was the winner for ninth grade. Her teacher is Mrs. Mercedes Phillips. Thank you for such a good job, LaIndia. All right.
At this time, I would like to present an award to Mr. Howard Byers. He is the district Young Achiever. Howard, congratulations. You're not just our MC this afternoon, you're also the district Young Achiever. Thank you for everything you've done in representation of Dr. Martin Luther King.
One of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s notable speeches that emphasizes the concept of unconditional love is his sermon titled Loving Your Enemies. He delivered this sermon at Dexter Avenue Baptist Church in Montgomery, Alabama on November 17, 1957. In this speech, Dr. King reflects on the teachings of Jesus Christ and advocates for the transformative power of love, even toward those who may oppose or mistreat you. In the sermon, he speaks about the Greek word agape, which signifies an unconditional, selfless love. Dr. King encourages his audience to embody agape love in their lives and interactions, especially when dealing with enemies. He argues that this form of love has the power to break the cycle of hatred and violence, promoting reconciliation and understanding. While the specific phrase unconditional love might not be explicitly mentioned in this speech, the essence of the message revolves around the idea of loving others without conditions, even in the face of adversity. The concept of unconditional love is a recurring theme in many of Martin Luther King Jr.'s speeches and writings as he sought to promote nonviolent resistance and social justice through the transformative power of love. Martin Luther King Jr.'s message about love remains timeless and relevant to today's youth. His teachings on love were not just about romantic or familial love, but extended to a broader concept of agape love, an unconditional, selfless love for all humanity. Here are some key aspects of Martin Luther King Jr.'s message about the love that can resonate with today's youth. Social justice. King emphasized the concept of agape love, a love that seeks the well-being of others without expecting anything in return. This love extends beyond personal relationships to encompass a commitment to social justice and the well-being of the entire community. Nonviolence. King's philosophy of nonviolent resistance was rooted in love. He believed that responding to hate with hate only perpetrates a cycle of violence. Instead, he advocated for responding to injustice with love and understanding, aiming to transform hearts and minds. Individual responsibility. King encouraged individuals to take personal responsibility for fostering positive change. His message to today's youth would likely be a call to action, urging them to use their voices and actions to address contemporary social issues with love and compassion. Education. King valued education and believed in the power of empathy. He would likely emphasize the importance of understanding different perspectives, engaging in open dialogue, and educating oneself about the struggles and challenges faced by others. Lastly, using technology and social media for change. Considering the prevalence of technology and social media, King might encourage today's youth to leverage these platforms for positive social change. Advocacy, awareness, and education can be amplified through the interconnectedness provided by modern communication. In essence, Martin Luther King Jr.'s message about love for today's youth would likely involve a call to action, a commitment to justice, and the understanding that love has the power to bring about transformative change in individuals and society as a whole.